much for joining us today.
You're welcome.
With this interview, we hope to learn a bit more about yourself. And we hope to give the prospective students an insight into your experience and your life at UDEL to the student. So yeah, can you please tell us a bit more about yourself?
Well, I'm Joren de Wit. I started aerospace engineering back in 2005. And yet graduated in 2014, so I took a long time, as many students do, and I do not regret it at all, because during my studies I was a member of a student fraternity all the time that I studied. I lived in Delft, and currently I work for Thales. Do you want to go into that as well already, or?
At some point we will go into that as well. But let's start first with why you chose TU Delft and why you chose aerospace engineering.
Well, I graduated high school, and then after that I didn't really know what I wanted to do. I knew that I liked aircraft, and I knew that I wanted to go to university. But then it had to be a technical study, because I really really like technical stuff. And I started looking around, started to go to these university, not career fairs, but university fairs, to just see what's around there. And actually I had a friend of mine who studied aerospace engineering already. So he basically introduced me in the aerospace engineering world, and then I went to the open day of the faculty, and that made me so enthusiastic that I just wanted to study aerospace engineering.
That's super cool. I studied that as well, so that's really, really cool. Okay, and what did you like the most during your bachelor here?
During my bachelor? I think that was being a member of fraternity Vergil. Really, I combined my bachelor's and my studies with also the student life, and I think that during my bachelor's I enjoyed the student life most.
Yes, that's great. That's great. And what is something that you found challenging during your bachelor and you managed to overcome? How did you do that?
During my bachelor, that was adapting to the pace, the study pace that was given here in university. Yeah. I came from high school, of course, and then I had to adapt to how do things go here? And then after that, that's something I struggled with. Not for very long, because I had a good this friend of mine that also went to TU Delft.
Yeah.
He helped me, and also just by asking for help, I say, hey, I cannot manage on my own. Can you help me, please?
Yeah. So it's important to ask for help when you need it, right?
Yeah.
Definitely, definitely. And then after your bachelor, what did you do for your master? Did you also do it here at TU Delft?
Yeah, I did my master at TU Delft as well. I did a master in control and simulation, and I did a master in control simulation, period.
Yeah, that's great. And also during your master, did you do an internship by any chance?
I did an internship at Boeing Research and Technologies in Madrid.
Ah, that's
beautiful. Yeah, it's something that I really liked.
Yeah, and what did you learn during that experience there? Any new skills that you learned?
That was mainly living abroad for the first time on my own. Of course, I was on holiday with my parents and with friends. But never on my own, and this isn't a holiday, and this is working.
Yeah.
So, and I learned there the business life. Boeing is a really large company, and to be able to have an internship over there was quite an opportunity.
Beautiful. Yes. And after that, you start with your thesis, right? Your master thesis.
Yeah.
What did you do for your thesis?
My thesis was about runway planning, creating a tool for runway planning efficiency, and. I built some software. Now I continue to further build some software that was already being developed within the faculty. And after that, I graduated on that topic.
That sounds pretty interesting.
Yeah.
And then, what was your first job after you graduated, and how did you manage to find this job?
My first job after my graduation was my traineeship at TNO, basically here in Delft. And I found it just by looking at vacancies. I knew that I liked aerospace engineering a lot, but I didn't know what I liked outside aerospace engineering and aviation in general. So that's why the traineeship that I came across appealed to me. Having the opportunity to discover further during a 2-year period basically having 2 years of time not dedicating myself to anything already.
Just discovering, exploring first, right? And figuring out what you really want to do.
Really, yeah.
Yeah, that's great. And then did you stay at TNO for longer after the traineeship program?
Yeah, that lasted for 2 years. Mm-hmm. And after that, I stayed at TNO at my last department of my traineeship. And then as a project manager, I spent 5 more years at TNO.
That's impressive. That's really nice. And how did you continue your career from there?
After TNO, I joined Thales Nederland. At the company at which I work right now as well. Mm-hmm. I started there as a system engineer, really content driven job, because I thought that as a project manager at TNO I drifted away from my background, which was very technical. Mm-hmm. Only I did only consultancy projects at TNO, which isn't very technical anymore. So I decided, okay, I need to go back to my roots, so to say.
Yeah.
And I found a vacancy at Thales Nederland for this combined role of system engineer and also a little PM project management role. And over the summer, after I joined at July 1st, 2020, over the summer I noticed that I got more energy from the little part of project management that was in my role.
Yeah.
And actually I moved towards project management more and more. And currently I'm project manager at Thales.
Well then.
And that's how things flow.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's really great. And what do you like most about working at Thales now? About the work environment?
Oh, good question. In Corona times it's difficult, but mm-hmm. For sure these are my colleagues. The people I work with, those are the ones I get energy from, and those are the ones that I like most to be around all day.
Yeah, that's great. And also, what skills that you developed here at TU Delft really helped you afterwards in your career?
My analytical thinking, mm-hmm. Really that helps me. For example, in my projects, I need to understand what the customer wants, what he asks, and what we can deliver. So I get a question from a customer, and they say, okay, we want to have this and this and this, can you deliver that? And then my analytical brain starts rolling and starts spinning, and then in my head I already think of a little bit of a solution. And I test that with my content-driven colleagues, because I'm only the project manager and I'm not the technical lead, for example. I test that with them, mm-hmm. and then they come up with a proposal for the client. And if the client says, yes, I like you to execute this project for me, then I go ahead.
Yeah, so that comes pretty easy after graduating from TU Delft. If you feel like it really helped shape your brain in such a way that you have problem solving skills and just analytical thinking, right?
Yeah, and also during my projects, that helps me in executing a project, in the sense that I need to lead my project team. And when they come across an issue, my analytical thinking helps me to help them solve that issue.
Yeah, that's great. So you're also helping others with the skills that you managed to get here. So
in the end, yes.
Yes. That's awesome. And do you have any recommendation or any advice for current and prospective students here at TU Delft?
Broaden your view outside your study field. Really, I had so much benefit of all the extracurricular activities I undertook during my studies. For example, as I said, being member of Vigiel, doing the technique driver talents. The career event, during the introduction weeks of Vigiel.
Yeah.
Having all these organizing skills outside my really educational and technical background, that made me a much more qualified person to be accepted in this traineeship.
Yes, so you should really not be afraid to do something outside of your studies, to broaden yourself in that sense, to maybe spend a bit of time on this, so maybe take an extra year, but do something that will definitely help you afterwards.
I would recommend that, because it makes you more complete.
Exactly, it's not just knowledge; it's also
there's more to life than only studying.
Exactly,
develop yourself as a person as well, please.
Yeah, you can really do this here at TU Delft in the study environment, and also with the people here; they're all open-minded. So, yeah, that is great. Well, thank you so much. for being here today.
You're welcome.
And,